हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, आय एम कुलदीप पुकाळे. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ऑफ मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग टेक्नॉलॉजी सब्जेक्ट. मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग टेक्नॉलॉजी, देन वॉट इज मीन बाय मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग? मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग मीन्स टू मेक समथिंग इन लार्ज क्वांटिटीज बाय यूजिंग machines. There are main two types of manufacturing. First is conventional manufacturing process. Second is non-conventional manufacturing process. Basic difference in between them: in conventional machining process, there is a tool is directly contacted with the workpiece. In this method, cutting tool is always harder than workpiece. And in non-conventional machining process, there is no any contact with tool and workpiece. In this method, material removal occurs with or without chip formation. Now we will see first conventional machine tools. In that first, in unit first, we are going to study conventional lathe machine. It is center lathe machine. In this chapter, we will detail study of main parts and their functions, specifications of lathe machine, accessories and attachments, lathe operations, processing of simple component on lathe machine. This is actual lathe machine. Lathe, it is a basic machine used in anywhere. This is also known as king of workshop, because all types of operations can be performed on by using this lathe machine only. This is block diagram of actual block diagram of lathe machine. The main parts of lathe machines are legs, bed, headstock, tailstock, carriage. These are the main parts of lathe machine. Now we'll discuss one by one. The first part is a leg. This is bottommost part of machine used for supporting to all parts of machines. These are made up from grey cast iron. It absorbs vibrations during the machining time. Second part is a bed. The main function of bed is supports the all parts of machines. There are two types of beds. The first type is V type bed and second is flat type bed. Nowadays, combination of V and flat type bed are used in lathe machines. The material of bed is also grey cast iron. Next part is headstock. The main function of headstock to provide the motion to the spindle of lathe machine, and it is located at left side of the machine. There are two types of headstock. First type is a belt driven headstock, and second is geared headstock. The first type is belt driven headstock, and second type is all geared headstock. In belt driven headstock, cone pulleys and belt is used for the transmitting the motion purpose. And in geared headstock, gears are used. In belt driven headstock, it uses small and light workpiece manufacturing time, whereas geared headstock is used heavy workpiece manufacturing time. In headstock, there are two mechanisms are there. First is back gear mechanism, and second is tumbler gear mechanism. Now we'll see the first back gear mechanism. Back gear mechanism, it is used in belt driven headstock only. It is used for reducing the spindle speed in compact space. It is only applicable for belt driven headstock. Second mechanism is a tumbler gear mechanism. This mechanism is used for transmitting the motion from spindle to the lead screw. During this transmission, number of gears are used. These are shown in figure. This headstock is also called as live center of lathe because it is continuous revolving part of machine. So it is called as live center of machine. Now we will see the tailstock. The function of tailstock to support the long workpiece during the operation time. Sometimes it is also used for holding the cutting tools like drill, drill bits, etc. It is non-revolving part, so it is called as dead center. The location of tailstock is extreme end of machine at right side. It is mounted on bed and it can be moved on bed by using the guide wheels. Next part is a carriage. Main function of carriage is hold the tool and provide the movement of the tool in the both cross as well as longitudinal direction. The main parts of carriage assembly are first saddle, second cross slide, third compound rest, last one is tool post. We will see one by one. First, saddle. It is mounted on bed and it moves in longitudinal direction on bed. It structure as a alpha fate H. Next part is a cross slide. It provides the cross motion to the tool and it is mounted on saddle. This is the cross slide. This is mounted on saddle. compound rest. It is mounted on cross slide and it can move in circular path. Last part is a tool post. It is situated on the compound rest and its main function is hold the cutting tools. In carriage, there are two mechanisms are there. See, this is the 3D diagram of carriage. This is saddle, this is a cross slide, this is compound rest, this is a tool post. In carriage, there are two mechanisms are there. First is apron mechanism and second is half nut mechanism. Apron mechanism is used for providing the cross as well as longitudinal motion automatically. And half nut mechanism is used for automatic feeding purpose. So this is the main parts of the lathe machine. In next lecture, we will discuss about the lathe accessories and attachments. Thank you.